Andy, Evelyn Walsh, Trent Michaud, they are in the lead in the pairs competition with just one team left to come, so they can finish no lower than second, and they are with Alage.
Trent, Evelyn, great performance.
Thank
again,
you.
You guys looked really good out there. Talk to me about your thoughts on your performance.
We're so happy with it. This whole week was only for us, and we wanted to kind of knock out the outside noises, because there's a lot right now, and skate for ourselves and be really proud of the program we put out, and I think we are very satisfied.
Yes, for sure. You know, people always say Nationals is where we peak and it's where we throw our stuff together, but I definitely think we finally figured out to push everything aside and train with our own, just us on ourselves. It's our journey, it's our path. I definitely think we found that riding into this. I think every year it's been a new year for us, but, you know, from our first year senior. So there's that pressure. Then there's the next year having like Charlie and Luba come back. And then obviously this year with Eric and Vanessa and the whole Olympics. Like, so every year it's just been something. So we've learned to, we figure it out eventually, but we just, I think, need to learn from this, that we just got to find that at the beginning of the year and keep trusting ourselves and our coaching staff, because, you know, we trusted them today and yesterday, and it was awesome.
I think it's a beautiful perspective to keep. And, you know, I noticed that in your programs, especially this year, there's such a nuance in your free program, and, you know, you can see the quality of movement. So how much have you worked on this side of your skating? You seem so united, and I think this is really, really cool to see.
Yeah, I think that's always been the basis of a performance. Anytime we leave the ice, anything can happen, but we can always have a connection and connect to the music, and that's really important to us. And honestly, it's why we love skating. That's the side of it, and we don't want to lose that in the mix of the elements. So when it comes together with the elements, it's something special.
Yeah, for sure. I definitely think you know, we've always tried to find that from when we were junior. Obviously it's a lot about the tricks, and then it's trying to figure that all out. And for us, it definitely I think actually in COVID was a big thing for us, from your and Michelle's classes was where it really started with the movement and the just like being free. And like, then you go and watch like Patrick or yourself or, you know, Tessa and Scott, and they just let themselves be themselves and be free. So I definitely think that carried on a little bit, and then working on it with Paul Mack, and then Carol and Uris did our free program this year. So obviously working in with them and watching Paul and Piper train some days is just a really big eye opener of that aspect, because we want people to remember us for that as well.
Well, you can really tell. I felt it through the screen, and congratulations on all the work that you're doing. Good luck with the Olympic team announcement, and good luck with the rest of the season.
Thank
you very much.
Thank you for being here.
It seems like they've come around with a beautiful perspective on the sport and what they need moving forward. I loved how they were talking about shutting out the outside. Such a wonderful place for them to be right now.
Here's our final team of the afternoon at Christian Ward Towers, Michael Marinaro. They were at a loss to really explain their season heading into Canadians. They've been a top eight team internationally since they started competing together in 2014, but this fall and winter skated well below their potential, and they said this is going to be their final season. They just want to rediscover, they said, their joy of skating before their journey comes to an end.
Along with figuring out that triple twist and figuring out that triple toe and training these long programs, they've had to do some really deep soul searching this season as well, which is part of their growth as skaters and as people.
I don't know too many other sports where the athletes carry how they're feeling about themselves out onto the competitive stage more than this one.
You hide nothing on the ice. Everything is out in the open. Opening there with one of Kirsten and Mike's better triple twists that we've seen this season. Their big combination, triple sow, double toe, and perfectly executed.
You could hear the microphones picking up how the takeoffs and landings were matched perfectly.
Triple loop, not even a flinch on the landing. They mean business today. They wanted to go into the Olympics as Canadian champions, and they need to skate for it. Beautiful reverse lasso lift. the hardest lift we'll see because the female takes off backwards. So she's a little bit blind, going up over her partner's head. I always felt very unsettled in that moment. I was out of control, and I'm a control freak.
Trust your partner.
They're gonna take a little breather here and get ready for the second half. They're one of the few teams in the world that plans a side-by-side jump in the second half of the program. Single skaters get bonuses for that. Pairs do not. They don't really have a big advantage in points doing it. It's just a well-designed program to spread it out. Fighting through. Throw triple sow, their final big element. Not the best quality, but check mark done.
This smile on Michael's face.
I have a feeling with every element that's being done throughout this program, little pieces of the weight of the world that they feel on their shoulders are being lifted off with each element. This ease is coming through.
No doubt we are looking at the three-time Canadian champions, Kristen Moore Towers, Michael Marinaro, their best skate by far of this season. And that embrace just says it all, what they feel, the relief that they were finally able to skate like they know they can skate.
I think it's the first time we saw them smile throughout a performance all season, and that just speaks to their confidence that they feel now in the work that they've done leading into this event.
Heading back for their last international competition, Kirsten had posted something online of her as a 9-year-old little girl, and she said in that post that, you know, they had to get back to that feeling that she had when she was young and just rediscover that joy of skating. Easier said than done, but they have done it here at these Canadian championships. A transformation from that last competition to this one is
It was only
remarkable.
A month ago.
Yeah,
it wasn't that long ago. If they can do this in 1 month, what are they going to do in the next weeks leading into the Beijing Olympics should they be named to the team?
Nice unison.
I would assume so, but we're not going to jump to any conclusions. Nice unison on that side-by-side, triple sow, double toe, and beautiful throw, triple loop. Like I said earlier, I just felt like with each element that they executed, there was just a lightness and an ease to their energy.
Well, it's like Evelyn and Trent, who just finished skating before them, choosing a music that is like building slowly and has that grinding, emotional, churning feel to it. When you're making mistakes in a program like that, they're glaring. They're almost like highlighted. And so a program like this, where that was the biggest mistake, really built emotionally, and then to feel, as you said, the smiles and the actual instinctive emotions that was coming through them after everything they've been through, that was a great moment. We just needed the audience to take it over the top, but I still think that we felt it through the screens of, you know, into your living rooms at home.
It was very empowered, and it was a standing ovation performance. They created that without an audience.
Do I think, you know, feel free at home to stand up if you'd like. No problem. Hey, Bruno.
Coach Bruno Marcotte, who has been on that journey along with them this season as they've tried to find their why.
Let's see if we hear them.
The free program score.
And that is a season's best score, 139.52. Their previous best was just 123, and easily.
Oh, a score they haven't seen for a long time, and yeah, that's going to give them a lot of confidence.
They win the Canadian title.
This Mike has a lot of people to say hi to there.
He does, I know. I was trying to be quiet.
He's a popular guy.
You look at the difference between first and second place. Well, that's about 26 points. Stiletto and Deschamps finish in third place. And let's start with them. Their first time on the podium, Stiletto and Deschamps. And this will probably get them a berth to the Four Continents competition. What does it mean for a team like them?
The Four Continents competition is a big competition. You can get world standing points. You can win prize money. You get to establish yourself amongst the international judges.
You can get COVID. You can.
Well, hopefully not. But it is really important for them. They haven't competed at any major international events yet. This will be their first one.
Okay. And let's just quickly remember where they came from. Like 17 years, the skates were in the basement. She dusted them off and put them on and went skating. And now is a medalist at the Canadian Championships, not even her home country. Like, and now she's going to four. Whoa, it's very good.
Yeah, it is very good. Walsh and Michaud, they finished in second place. I know they still have to find out what happens as far as the Olympics are concerned. But what does this mean for their career, their confidence, and just their everything moving forward, I guess, for them?
They will have a competition after this, whether it is Four Continents or the Olympics or the World Championships. They will still compete, and they can keep on improving and making those improvements that we just saw between the Grand Prix circuit and here, and establishing their reputation with the international judges.
And quickly, Mortowers Marinero, just amazing performance in what was an extremely difficult year for both of them, and to come back, quick thoughts.
I think they did everything they needed to do to go to Beijing with their heads held high.
When you're the champion of the country, this is a launching pad for you. This is your party of going to the Olympics, and they've won. They're going, and I think this is the best send-off they could have asked for.
Okay, right now let's hear from the Canadian champions once again, Mortowers Marinero with Alage.
Michael, Kirsten, what a beautiful moment. What a way to top off these Canadian national championships. Talk to me about how you felt out there today.
Oh, it's an emotional day for us, for sure. We knew we were capable of that, but the season obviously hasn't gone how we've planned up until now. And so I think, though it wasn't perfect, we're just so proud of ourselves. And we really wanted to go into the Olympics as Canada's number one team. We wish that all the teams were competing today so that we could have really had that opportunity. But I think we're proud of ourselves, and I consider that our job is done for today.
Yes, definitely. It's been a struggle of a couple months leading into this, but having both of those performances plays a huge role with our confidence, with our mindset, and those programs are going to set us up for success in Beijing. Hopefully, we're named tomorrow.
And what are some of the ways that you, some of the things that you take away from this season? Because obviously, like you said, it was a tough season, but you came out here really strong. So what are the things that you learned, and how did you adjust coming into this?
I started using some different mental tools and working with a different mental prep. I loved the one that I was working with prior, but obviously when things don't go as planned, we need to kind of take a look in the mirror and make a change if that's what needs to be done. And so that's what we tried to do. And I think these new mental tools are working for me and have been helping this week. And we feel stronger as a team and more confident in our abilities because of the good practices and good training we've been putting in leading up to this event.
Yeah, it all comes down to our mental preparation, which we did very well of controlling this week 24/7 all three days that we've been here, and wasn't an easy competition. Everything here has been different than normal due to COVID, so if we can stick into our bubble under these conditions, obviously in Beijing it's not going to be normal conditions either. So with all these exterior factors, sticking to ourselves I think is a big success for us.
Well, still to come, the final event, the men's free, and there's a look at, isn't he cute, Wyatt Messing, the son of the man who will likely lead the Canadian men's team to Beijing next month, Keegan Messing. The Men are next on CBC Sports.